Hi, today we will show you how to create a project in Cognex Designer. What will be its structure on the disk? How can we save a project? How to restore from a backup and how to move it to another computer? So, I'm going to open Cognex Designer. In Cognex Designer, I click on New Project and name it Designer VisionPro Basics, for example. And I give him my prepared path to the program folder. And in project type, I'll select blank project because we're going to create an empty project. Here we have the opportunity to see some samples of single camera projects, that is one camera, multiple cameras, or independently more cameras, but now we are only interested in an empty project. We don't use any plugins now, so we can turn off what we have here and simply give accept. Now Cognex Designer creates both project and structure on disk. And it takes him quite a long time, depending on PC and how big the project is. So, if we already have an older project where there are a lot of things, and the bigger the project, the more things we have configured in it, the longer it takes to open it. But as we can see, Designer created a folder called Designer VisionPro Basics in the folder I assigned to it, as our project is called, and there are three folders in it: Data, Languages, and Recipes. These are the accompanying folders of that project where it stores some runtime variables. Where it stores information about languages, that is, if we have any localization of the project into different languages, it stores its own configurations and also recipes. Later we will show you what is actually here. We still don't have one file that's missing, and that's because we haven't saved this project yet. So, I can save the project via File Save All. We saw a saving visualization and Designer added a file that has the extension CDP, Cognex Designer Project. The Designer saved the current state to this CDP file where I saved the project, either via the Ctrl S button, or via this icon, or through the Save All menu. And as I see here at the bottom right, it shows me how long I didn't save the project. Last time it was saved 2 minutes ago, and all the changes I make here now in this project. All the changes, like I add a camera and so on, all changes are still stored only in memory, and if I would make this, that I close the project without saving it, I'll give don't save. And I want to open that project again, so I open Designer VisionPro Basics. So, I'll see that those changes didn't stay there. So, I look, I don't have anything in devices, I don't have anything in task. This means that Designer won't save any changes at all unless you do it manually or when you turn off the program via save. However, if we make some changes, for example, I add Cam1 some camera here. I add Simcam1 here, we can simulate them. I can throw in here that I'm going to pull from the camera. And now when I save the project, so I click this icon or Ctrl S. I added a new CDP file in my folder that has some timestamp. By that timestamp I know when I save the project, and it's actually just a copy of this project, this CDP, and saved with the timestamp when I made this change. And here is the current project with my new changes that I made. So, this is my current Cognex Designer project, and this is just a backup. If I keep saving Ctrl-S, 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 I will get more and more CDP files, which will only be backups, which are actually a backup of that CDP file that is without a timestamp. Now, one very important thing. This CDP file must have the same name as the parent folder. In order for Cognex Designer to be able to open this CDP file with this directory structure, the parent folder must have the same name as the CDP file we want to open. So, I look above and see that this Designer VisionPro Basics is of the same name as this .cdp file. If I want to go back to some backup, like the oldest backup we did, this one, I can rename this project. For example, Zaloha, just like that. I'll close this without saving. Because all these changes now if I do are only in memory and until I do save, actually no new CDP file will be created. I can show it. So I can try it. I will create a new CDP file with the current status of the project. So, I'm not interested in this one because I have that backup here, so I could delete it. I close the project without saving now and want to return to this backup. All I have to do is delete this timestamp. I'll do it by copying this file instead. And I delete this timestamp. And now when I open this project in Designer, I see that it is empty again. No cameras and there are no blocks in task, that is, we restored this file from a backup. I did it by copying that file so that I still had the file here if I wanted to return to it, although of course it's only for example now, so for me it's nonsense to go back to an empty project, but I always recommend doing it to copy the backup, not just change the name. Not just delete this, because then you don't know exactly what timestamp was there and you can't exactly go back to the state that now I can delete this one. I will use this backup. This is the latest one we had with the changes and this is still my project that I can return to if it is interesting for me. So, I'll try, not try, but open the latest project. By renaming the file from the backup to the same name with the parent folder, I can reopen it in the state it was last saved and keep working. You can see that I have cameras here and I have one camera block in my task. One big disadvantage of Cognex Designer projects is that they are not versionable, so they are binaries that we cannot use Git or Svun or similar things on top of them, and the only option is to back them up by actually naming those files. For example, that this could be the project before the lighting change project Predsmenables, so to know what it was about in that given project that is in that given state, I can name those CDP files in this way to know more precisely what it is, because if I had 100 files with different timestamps, I would hardly find the project, which was something interesting to me. And one more thing needs to be said, that the size is gradually adding new and new things to the project, so the size of the file is also increasing. We have no change here yet. But if you use some search tools where images are saved directly, then the change is quite significant and those projects can reach 300 megabytes without any problem. So with every single change, that is, with every single save of the project, you will pack another CDP file with about 300 megabytes of data, which means that sometimes this folder needs to be cleaned. If you want to move the project to another computer, for example, drag it over the network from the customer to yourself and make adjustments yourself, then all you need is the current CDP file you want to use or one of the backups. That's up to you. And then copy these three folders as well, although languages and recipes may be empty unless you use them, but there is always this runtime, DB3, in the data. So at least the data folder and CDP file needs to be taken. So, for example, if I want to move a project to another folder, and I can now show how to change the name of that project, I can do this by copying these four things. I'm going to create a new project here. Tutorial Projectist, for example, I'll name the new project. And in order to open the project in Designer, the CDP file must be called the same as the parent folder. And now what I can do is start Cognex Designer, open project, I navigate to that folder. So, I have set up tutorial projectist. Here I choose that folder and I put select folder. Even if I don't see that CDP file here, that's fine, it is there. It's just filtered out by the visualization. And now I get the same project that we had under a different name. You can see that the project is called tutorial projectist. And we can continue where we finished. So, this way I can copy a project from another computer and work on my own PC, for example, or on another computer. I'll go back to the project we had before. I delete this so that I am not misled by it and open Designer VisionPro Basics.